A bug triage is the process by which the severity of different bugs is determined, and we start to disambiguate between different bugs, and we basically try to get a handle on which bugs we can report in parallel. And so the deal is that any inputs that trigger separate bugs can be reported in parallel, but if we report all of the bug triggering inputs that we found, what we're going to do is be causing a lot of duplicate bug reports. And one of the golden rules of reporting bugs, and I'll go over this a little bit later in more detail, is that you don't report duplicate bugs. This wears on developers incredibly much, and they'll soon get tired of you and start ignoring you. And I say this from experience. I've reported quite a few duplicate bugs myself, and it's not that fun. People don't like it. So the question now is, what does bug triage mean? How do we start getting a handle on which bug triggering inputs map to different bugs and which ones map to the same bugs? And basically, there is no silver bullet here. What we have is, we're going to see is there's a number of different weapons we can use to disambiguate bugs. And so in the easiest possible case, the bugs in the system are causing assertion violation messages. So one thing we can do is disambiguate based on assertion violations. What I basically mean here is that you do what I gave a demonstration of doing a little bit earlier, which is you just look at the text of the assertion violation messages, and you go ahead and make the assumption that distinct assertion violation messages are caused by distinct bugs in the software under test. And that doesn't need to be true. Not too long ago, I reported something like 6 bugs in the LLVM compiler. They had completely distinct symptoms, that is to say, completely distinct assertion violation messages, but they were all traced back to a single error in the source code. And so, of course, that kind of thing can happen, and that's especially common if the underlying bug in the software under test is some sort of a memory safety violation. That is to say, we have a C or C++ program that starts corrupting its own internal memory, and in that case, a single bug can map to any number of symptoms. One possibility is that we have a single root cause, it's a defect in the software under test, that can map multiple outputs that look different. So this is one possibility, and this happens, although maybe not that often. Another possibility is that we can have multiple defects that all cause the same symptom. And this is actually really common. For example, in a big C or C++ program like a web browser, it's very common for multiple memory safety defects, that is to say multiple bugs that include things like buffer overruns and null pointer dereferences, to all have the same symptom, which is segmentation fault. So that happens really commonly. Now, in contrast with these slightly pathological cases, what we hope happens, and this is also relatively common, is that a single defect maps to a single symptom, and by reporting a test case leading to that symptom, we can get that defect fixed. And so in this case, if we have many defects all mapping to their own symptoms in the output space, we can report these in parallel. And that's really nice. And like I was saying, with large, complicated software that's evolving rapidly, reporting bugs in parallel may be our only option if we want to actually get the number of defects in the software under control.